As we are all with the hectic activities, with the hornbill activities going side by side, but in spite of that, I would like to thank you all for coming forward to see and hear the progress of work and the activities in whatever way that is best that can we do for the department and for the state as a whole. So, like, with these few words, I would like you to take your time and we can go ahead with the interaction. And of course, at the same time, the program officer for the vaccination, Dr. Ritu, is here. Dr. Niang, who is in charge for disease surveillance program, he is here. So on certain issues, in whatever way, Director of Family Welfare is here. So like, in whatever way that we can share with you, we will do that. So now it is open up to you to come forward with in what way we want to take on. So till as of today, in the country as well as within the state, there is no reported case of this Omicron virus. But as per the information that we have received from the government of India, due notification has been given to all the districts, whatever steps that is necessary to be taken, the advisories have been given to the DTF and to all the chief medical officers in the districts. And with particular focus, with the upcoming Hornbill Festival, we have taken due precaution with due information to the government and as well as to the districts of Dimapur and Kohima, that a special COVID care management center has to be created. And at the Hornbill Festival site, a medical team will be stationed there to do their due duty in whatever way that is to be followed. And we have been in touch with the tourism department, and all the due SOPs and whatever advisory that is required from the department, this has been shared with them. And whatever activities that we have performed so far, this has been communicated to the government. And this Omicron virus, this is the B.1.1.1529. This is a virus which suddenly we cannot pass any clear-cut information. But, you know, according to the scientists, they said that this is a virulent strain. And this has already spread to more than 22 countries as of the latest report that we have had with us. Now, according to the latest news that we have received, the fatality in patients, this has not been recorded. It was being said that with mild headache, throat irritation, and general weakness. This is the symptom which in South Africa, where it was first detected, these are the symptoms which they have shared in the global arena. Now, even there itself, the scientists are saying that how fatal it will be, how virulent it will be, that in the course of time we will come to know. But like as I have said, till as of today, there is no reported case in the country and whereas within the state, and for which due precautions have been taken for visitors, especially during this Hornbill Festival, to do all the necessary screening at Dimapur and at Kohima. Yeah, as of now, we have sufficient rapid antigen test kit available. As of today, like as I said, as there is no reported case for this new variant, so all the advisories, whatever we have to furnish, we have given to the government. The final decision is with the government. So we cannot come out with a clear-cut advisory. Whatever we are to give to the government, it is already furnished. And of course, if God forbid, we have the BSL-3 lab at Kohima, and all the genome sequencing samples will come to the BSL-3 at Kohima, and we are in contact with Manipur and the other metro cities as well, where we can do this testing. So in case if any inbound passenger coming to the state, if suspected, they will be isolated, they will be screened, and immediately such cases we are going to send for genome sequencing. Reported in the metro cities, schools open up, and then suddenly in terms of 100, 100, 200 students are getting infected. This sort of reporting is coming in the media. No, as such, there is no need for a lockdown at this present juncture. Because in the last 7-8 days, death reported is only one. The hospital admission is well below 20 margin all over the state. And the positivity rate stands at 1.7. National advisory says if it is below 5%, then you can safely declare it open. But now in our context, it is at 1.7, so there is no such thing as a total lockdown now, as of now. Case level at the district level in the rural areas, especially when there is rejections, objections by the public. Keeping this well in mind, we have already called all the chief medical officers, the district immunization officers, and with due information to the district task force, along with the principal secretary and the medical minister, we have had a whole day session here in the department. And due focus was given for further vaccination to improve the vaccination, and for which extra funds have been given to the district level. And in the last 1 week or so, I think there is some improvement in the activities of this vaccination program. You're from this or that department, the COVID appropriate behaviors and further advisories in whatever way that we have mentioned, the public should be made aware, and the media can still further elaborate on these issues to the public in the coming days. That is one thing. And of course, I missed out one point whereby for this Hornbill Festival activity, proper monitoring, checking at Dimapur, Kohima, and of course I forgot Mon, because inbound passengers may come to Dibrugarh by flight, they may enter Mon and come to the rest of the districts, and for which even proper advisories and preparedness to be there in place, we have already served a notice to even Mon district. And for you to give you a clarity on the status of vaccination of first dose at the national figure, it stands at 85% first dose vaccination, whereas in our state we are at 59.1, and for the second dose the national average is 40%, whereas we stand at 43.8%. Notification served to the departments. Universal masking, that is one. The other is vaccination of domestic visitors that we have to focus on. A medical stall with COVID-19 vaccination facility shall be there. Symptomatic visitors shall not be allowed to enter into the event. Testing booth will be made available in the first aid stall. All possible measures shall be taken to avoid overcrowding. Hand washing points with soap and water shall be made available in all the strategic points. There shall be continued messaging on COVID-19 vaccination, use of masks and other safety measures through announcements and other IEC platforms. So, as mentioned, a medical staff with COVID-19 vaccination facility shall cater to everyone willing to get vaccinated for the entire 10 days for both first and second dose. So in that very place, all eligible domestic visitors, including artists, performers, shall produce vaccination certificate in soft oblique, hard copy or SMS form, AXNHPSMS, unless medically contraindicated. Visitors shall be given the option to vaccinate at the venue with a valid photo ID. This policy shall apply to all events under the Hornbill Festival. See, how can the medical department go around to all the places and take everything under our control? There is a government and the tourism department, whatever advisories that we are to give, we have already given. Maybe home department at the level, in whatever way they want to do, they can do. This is a effort that has to be generated from a
collective effort.
Everyone. So when the SOPs are being served, public should be aware of how we should go about. Throughout the event, we cannot run up and down. The medical team cannot do all these activities for the sake of this event. So, basing on the advisories and SOPs, whatever is being given, it should be followed. See what?
As long as I think overcrowding will not be allowed, but we are sure festival overcrowding cannot be allowed.
No. See, we are not the government. We, as a department, we furnish all the details to the war room, headed by the chief secretary. And all the concerned departments are there in the discussion. So whatever advisories that are being generated by the medical department, as per that, they have already given out to all the departments to follow. So it has to be looked after by the law enforcing agency, administration, the hosting department and things like that. There should be a full-fledged cooperation and it should be executed out, because this blame cannot be put on the head of the medical department alone. For Kohima, Merema has been earmarked, but for Dimapur and Mon, the communication has not reached us yet. But we have already told them to get it prepared. Yeah, that to every district, it goes without saying that the COVID hospital will remain functional. But in case of a super spreader happening event, then the COVID care center has to be standby.
Nagaland TV, Sop Manulaga Awas. Watch us live on Jio TV and on your television sets as well. For Dimapur viewers, we are on channel number 10 in Global Chapter. And for Kohima and Mokokchung viewers, switch to channel number 138 on Hornbill Digital. For all news and updates, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube and Twitter.